Thank you, colleagues. So the indications for NAD1 chemotherapy are the stage of the disease, especially regional nodal involvement, and the biological subtype of breast cancer. But regional nodal involvement is an indication for axillary lymph node dissection too. So nowadays, NAD1 systemic therapy is a frequent treatment choice for primary operable disease. Why? Because NAD1 chemotherapy is a predictor of breast cancer survival. It's a tool for determining adjuvant systemic therapy, and it's a tool for omit axillary lymph node dissection. So axillary lymph node dissection is a very harmful procedure with such complication as lymphedema, axillary web syndrome, which can occur in 20 till 40% of all axillary lymph node dissection cases. But we should understand that over the past 40 years, the development of systemic therapy has led to an increase in the survival of breast cancer patients. But at the same time, surgery is the main component in the complex breast cancer treatment, and it's a foundation for effective systemic therapies. So we achieve pathologic complete response up to 80% of neoadjuvant treatment cases, especially in triple negative breast cancer and HER2 positive breast cancer. And if we're talking about nodal PCR after neoadjuvant chemotherapy, the frequency in triple negative breast cancer is up to 60%, and in HER2 positive up to 70% of all of the cases. So this is one of the reasons to omit axillary lymph node dissection after neoadjuvant chemotherapy. So the past 10 years, frequency of sentinel lymph node biopsy increased from 28% to 68%, and frequency of axillary lymph node dissection decreased from 100% to 38% of cases. So in our center, for the last 6 years, we start to make sentinel lymph node biopsy 4 times more. And nowadays we perform this procedure for, I think, about 70% of all our patients. So one of the reasons of increasing rate of sentinel lymph node biopsy is the possibility to perform this procedure after neoadjuvant chemotherapy in clinically node negative patients. And the false negative rate is not higher than in primary cases. It's about 8%. So sentinel lymph node biopsy is the international standard of care for axillary surgical staging in primary patients and in patients before the NAD1 chemotherapy without lymph node involvement. But when we talk about sentinel lymph node biopsy in clinically node positive disease after complete response to neoadjuvant chemotherapy, we have more questions than answers. So one of the main problem of sentinel lymph node biopsy after neoadjuvant chemotherapy is high false negative rate, more than 10%. And Z1071, Sentina, and SenfNec trials showed that false negative rate is lower when we remove more sentinel lymph nodes. So there are two ways to reduce false negative rate of sentinel lymph node biopsy. First way, we should increase number of sentinel lymph nodes, and another way, we should search for new methods. So one of the methods to decrease false negative rate and increase number of sentinel lymph nodes is double mapping of sentinel lymph nodes. In Sentina, Allianz, and SNFNAC trials, false negative rate was lower than 10% And in our center trial, the identification rate of sentinel lymph node with combination of ICG and radioisotope was 99%. But we think that philosophy of sentinel lymph node biopsy is achieving results with minimal surgical intervention on the axillary lymph nodes. So we can use the metastatic lymph node pathomorphism to identify residual tumor after neoadjuvant chemotherapy. And the most suitable lymph node for assessing the effect of systemic therapy is a lymph node with biopsy-proved metastatic involvement before neoadjuvant chemotherapy. So, what are the possibilities of determining the initially metastatic lymph node? We can clip this node before neoadjuvant chemotherapy. We can do dye introduction. We can palpate this metastatic lymph node. We can do ultrasound examination. We can map this lymph node. But the false negative rate is lower when we can find the marked lymph node during the surgery, during the sentinel lymph node biopsy, not in axillary lymph node specimen. So, how to find the right lymph node if they look all the same? So, the evolution of sentinel lymph node biopsy is target axillary dissection. And nowadays, marking the lymph nodes before neoadjuvant chemotherapy is the standard of care in NCCN. So, how we can mark the lymph node? We can use clips. We can use microsheets with radioisotope with paramagnetics. So, in our center, I would like to tell you about our trial. It's a metastatic lymph node mapping prior to neoadjuvant therapy and target axillary surgery after neoadjuvant therapy. So, first of all, we use ultrasound for identify patients with lymph node involvement. We prove lymph node involvement using fine needle biopsy, and then we instillate the microsheet with iodine 135 radioisotope in a metastatic lymph node. So this is the procedure, and in this picture you can see the seed in a metastatic lymph node by ultrasound. So when we perform adjuvant chemotherapy according to biological subtype of a tumor, and we detect the marked lymph node during surgery and perform the sentinel lymph node biopsy with technetium. So we do target axillary lymph node dissection and sentinel lymph node biopsy with gamma finder. And when perform intraoperative assessment of removed lymph nodes. So, what are the advantages of seeds with iodine? So, first of all, it's fixation in the lymph node without migration of the seed. Second, these seeds listens in Russian Federation for cancer patient treatment, for prostate cancer, for brachytherapy, low dose brachytherapy, and mainly, it's a possibility for intraoperative detection of a lymph node with a seed using a gamma probe. So we don't need the additional expensive equipment. So in this picture, you can see the sentinel lymph node with the clip with iodine microsheet. So the intermediate results of our trial. So seeds were placed in 25 patients with breast cancer with second stage. Surgery was performed for 6 patients, and 19 patients still received chemotherapy. And in all 6 surgery cases, marked lymph node was detected as a sentinel lymph node during the surgery. We don't have enough information for oncological safety of omitting axillary lymph node dissection in cases of downstaging from N-positive to N-negative patients. I think the biggest trial is the study of European Institute of Oncology from Milan. It's about 147 patients. The median follow-up is 61 months, and axillary relapse was in one case. It's interesting, it was a case with axillary lymph node dissection. So, and what are the questions about sentinel lymph node biopsy nowadays? So, the first question, according to Antoni van Leeuwenhoek Cancer Center, sentinel lymph node biopsy can be safely omitted in some group of patients. So, not only sentinel lymph node biopsy, but all the surgery in axillary area. So, especially in HER2 positive breast cancer and triple negative breast cancer without clinical nodal involvement. So maybe its ability to omit surgical staging of the axilla after neoadjuvant chemotherapy in some patient subgroups for first and second stage of a breast cancer without lymph node involvement in HER2 positive and triple negative cases. So according to Z0011 trial, primary patients with positive sentinel lymph nodes don't get additional benefit from axillary lymph node dissection. So the Alliance 11202 trial should answer the question of axillary lymph node benefit, axillary lymph node dissection benefit for patients with positive sentinel lymph node after neoadjuvant chemotherapy. So another trial, AMAROS, showed that primary patients with sentinel lymph node involvement and axillary lymph node dissection don't get additional benefit from radiation therapy. So trial B51 should prove oncological safety of omitting radiation therapy in cases of lymph node pathological complete response after neoadjuvant chemotherapy. So maybe in future neoadjuvant chemotherapy will be as good as radiation therapy in adjuvant treatment. So nowadays, sentinel lymph node biopsy in primary node negative patients is a worldwide standard of care and in Russian Federation too. The sentinel lymph node biopsy in node negative patients after neoadjuvant chemotherapy is our center standard of care. And sentinel lymph node biopsy after neoadjuvant chemotherapy, when the stage of original lymph node downstaged from N-positive to N-negative is a good method, but we should use double mapping of the sentinel lymph nodes, or we should mark the positive lymph nodes before the neoadjuvant treatment. So, dear colleagues, thank you for your attention.